Hello and welcome to Railsware Academy. My name is Anastasia and today we'll continue discovering Google Sheets. In our previous video, we have learned how to create simple drop-down lists using data validation. Today we'll build business metrics monitors using data validation, filter formula, and dependent drop-down lists. I will also show you some tips and tricks on how you can format your formulas to make them readable and how to use the color coding. While watching the video, consider subscribing. Imagine we want to have an income monitor based on the locations. We have clients from different regions, countries, and cities. We want the results to change depending on the exact location we select. Let's create a dependent dynamic drop-down list. For this, I have a separate tab called Income Monitor. I recommend you to store data sources and calculations on separate tabs. Now let's mark the monitor and freeze the first row, as it will contain headers. I do it by pulling this marker. You can do the same with columns if needed. Then I mark where I will have region, country, and city in the monitor. Now we apply the standard data validation to the region. I click on the cell, use Ctrl+Option+D, and then press V. In the menu, I select the list from range and select the regions column in payments tab. Don't forget to specify the whole column in the criteria field so that you don't miss anything when the new data is entered. A great feature of data validation in Google Sheets is that it automatically pulls the unique values to the drop-down list so that you don't see duplicates. I will also pull unique regions to the list on the right for it to be visible. It will be easier to validate the region based on the list in the same tab, so I will use these values for data validation in the monitor. To add a header right in the formula, use the braces. We start from the header and then write down the formula. Regions as our header, semicolon. Then I pull unique values from regions column in payments tab. I split the formula into few lines for it to become readable. For each formula nested in the previous one, start from a new line. For Mac, I use Ctrl+Enter. I can't use tab in the formula, so I add two spaces instead. This doesn't affect the formula, but simplifies your perception a lot. Now, we apply the standard data validation to the region.
It will be easier to see the list of cities only from the selected countries and regions, and not to remind myself whether Bergen is in Sweden or Norway every time. So let's use the dependent drop-down lists.
For this, I will create few helpers. First, I need to use the filter formula to list the countries from the selected region. Learn how to use filter formula by watching our tutorial. We write down the header countries, semicolon, and the filter formula. We need to filter the countries where the region is equal to the one selected in our monitor. Don't forget to select the whole column as a range. We type braces, countries in quotes as a header, semicolon, then filter, select the range to filter, countries column in payments, and the criteria to match, the region column in payments to match the region selected in the monitor. Make sure you've formatted your formula and hit enter. Okay, so now we have the whole list of countries from the selected region filtered out here. To get rid of the duplicates, I apply unique to the filter. This will pull the unique values from the filtered list. Now, if you select a different region, the countries list will change as well. Let's apply data validation to the country in our monitor. Ctrl+Option+D, then V. We select the countries from the row number 2. Now, if the region changes, the country might get marked as invalid. You can also reject input in the data validation menu, but I'll skip this one for now. We do the same for the city validation, but here we need two conditions in the filter formula for both region and country to match. So I add one more condition. Type the braces, header in quotes, cities, use unique, then we use filter, set to filter, and two criteria, countries to match the one in the monitor, and the region to match the one in the monitor.
Now, if for some reason region and country do not match, for example, I changed the region but not the country yet, the cities list won't show. This is an additional reminder for you to select the matching region and country. We now add the cities range as a criteria to validate city in our monitor by applying data validation. We click on the cell, use Ctrl Option D, then press V, select list from a range, and state the range. We can also reject input and add a note to select a city from the offered list.
If your spreadsheet is used by multiple users and you want to mark the structure, use the color coding. Color cells with formulas and cells with dynamic data to make sure that nobody rewrites those.
Use different colors for outputs and calculations. Watch our video about formatting spreadsheets where we explain the color coding in more detail. Finally, we decide what we want to see. For example, I want to see the total income from the clients in the city I've chosen. I use Sum filter, then select the payments column from the data source as the one to be filtered, and select the criteria to match the values above. Region in the data source to match the region selected in the monitor. The same goes for the country and for the city. To trap and manage errors, I apply IFERROR. If the error occurs, I add a message, check if region, country, and city match. And here it is, the sum of the payments based on the multiple criteria. You can apply this approach to different contexts, to see the list of clients in the region, to track unpaid invoices, etc. Combine this approach with other formulas like filter to get the expected outcomes. I can use filter to pull all of the info about clients and their payments based on the region, country, and city we select. For this, I add headers first. Open braces and pull headers from the data source, from A1 to H1. Then we put semicolon and type IFERROR, filter, values from columns A2 to H, and the filter criteria, region, country, and city to match the values from the monitor. Now, if all criteria match, you will see a list of payments from different clients below. If criteria is empty or does not match, the list will be empty as well. Watch our video about advanced tips and tricks for using filter formula to see how this works.
You can add this approach to your Google Sheets library and continue watching our tutorials. Press thumbs up if you like this video and leave your questions or suggestions in the comments. Subscribe to our channel and press the bell not to miss a thing. See you next time!